So basic model is ready, and you see I reduced it maximum as much as possible. I reduced it now.
Yeah.
And every, you can see most of things are quad, there are like few triangles, but because this style is going to repeat a lot of times, so that's why to keep everything optimized, I need to update it and fix everything. So now the basic first style is ready. And let me open your reference once again. And I can see you have sent me a MTL file material.
Yes, sir. Actually, I clicked on OBJ, but for some reason it's changing it into material.
No, check the same folder. Whenever you export OBJ, it creates two files. One is your OBJ, one is your .mtl with the same name. So check it, cross check it. There must be another file with under like extension OBJ. Same name, same folder.
Yes, sir. I'll check it, sir.
Close it. Okay. You sent me. Okay. Joined back. Okay. So let your reference, I open it and let's start. Create this thing. So I feel this is like way too long, elongated. So I'll reduce the scale. And curve wise, not that curved. So I'll just fix the curve. Let's select all three of them. Make it a little bit more curved. Now we have this nice curved tile, one tile. So now I want to create that entire shape. So how will I do it is the easiest way. I'll just keep it a little angle. Oh, sorry, not this angle, like this angle, maybe 10, 15 degrees, 6 degree, so that whenever I duplicate this, it overlap this shape. So I can create instances if I want. So it will make my life way easier. So now in my reference, I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 of them. So duplicate 7. So see, instantly 8 of them are ready. Now I want to now I can see the reference 8 I counted. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 yes, 6 of this section. So I'll create that. So all of them are ready. Select. Five. So five are ready. See? Entire thing. So everything I'm creating on the floor, on the ground, once I'm done with this, then I'll rotate and create the angle. So now you can see my basic structure is ready. Only those in between cylinders are missing. So I'll go back, create a cylinder. Then I can go to top front view. So I got this thing. So I have in between those grooves. I have some 1, 2, 3 surface. Okay. And this thing, cap segment. If I add 2, so I'll get everything nicely covered. So now, in between everywhere, you can see the same cylinder continues.
Yes, sir.
And it's like this. And this surface is rotated, right? It's not like this. It's like angled. So polygon, face, select this face, rotation, create the rotation and move it up so it looks fine. And if I don't want all this like distortion or any problem, I can just simply remove all the edges from in between. Those are not required, right? So you can see my basic structure is ready. Now this surface have a little detail as well. So because just to keep the, because it's angled, just to keep the thickness even throughout, I'll scale it up slightly and shift. What happened? You can hear me. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We can hear you, sir. Okay.
So, okay, so not no extrude, inset. Inset it nicely and then extrude inside. Create that effect.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me.
Your voice is cutting, sir. I cannot hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Hello. Now I can hear you.
Okay. So I'll create the basic structure. So see, my basic shape is ready. I can select this thing, inset, and collapse. So my basic structure, see, is ready. And this part, if I want, I can keep it. If it's not visible, I can delete also. And in between those grooves, that is, we can do it in normal map, or we can, if we want, we can create in mesh also. Like if you want to keep it like really nice, like a nice detailed model, so you can keep it as like loops. So I'll go like select all the edges. All the edges, I want 1, 2, 3. I have in between 3 grooves. So connect 3. So I have 3 grooves. Each and every groove, I need to like create, extrude that section. So I can keep them select. I can shatter them the way I want. I can chamfer them nicely. Okay, chamfer them, and so everything is equal distance and clean. And I believe there should be another. There should be one more loop here. So I can go to it and loop. Create. Now all of them are selected nicely, and now I need to select all those faces. Shift, control, and then press shift. Control and all ring selected. Now I can simply extrude it in normal direction, local normal.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can hear you.
Sir, your voice is lagging, sir. I cannot hear you for a while, and a little bit echo is also there, sir.
Miss, give me a second.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I don't know, maybe like because electricity is a issue. So because of that, some like network problem, something is happening. I'm not sure about that. Okay. Now this thing is ready. From top view, I can see it clearly. Now, wherever I want to place it, like center, shift, center, So I have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. So that means 4 times I have to duplicate. See? Go to perspective. Now you can see my basic structure is ready. Basic structure is ready. Everything is like fine. And all these detail, like I can see like this little bit penetration. That is something like in first part or like when I'm creating the first tube, that time only I should fix it. And my basic structure, the entire structure is ready. Now I can see there is a one more cylinder here. Those things I can keep it later. And this entire thing I need to like right click, convert to poly. So previously it was instances, now it's all like its entire thing is polygons now. Now if I want I can select them, I can group them together or I can attach them together. So let's attach everything attached together. Now that bend we need, right? That bend we need. So what I'll do, so my basic structure, entire structure is ready. Now I need to bend it. That's it. Bend it. It's bent. The entire section is ready. Now for this thing, I can see in the reference, the top part is slightly curved. Slightly, the slight curve is there. So if I want to create that, I can definitely use FFD and create this. And the sides I have to create separately. You can see I have this thing corner, this corner and this side part. So how will I do it? To generate that section, I need to duplicate this. I already have this thing. I duplicate one more, this side, it's already there. And I have like few horizontal lines, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 of them. Select element by, select this thing, shift and drag, object mode, separate the model. Now select this one, I have a separate model altogether. Center the pivot point. Top view, and make sure rotate it into 90 degree, perfect 90, perfect 90 degree angle. Okay. Here it looks perfectly 90 degree. So here I have only one groove and rest is not there. So I'll go to polygon mode, delete all the polygons, and anything which is not okay. Wrong selection, delete, 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 delete. So now I have this shape. Now front view also I need to rotate and make sure it's like straight. Go to perspective. Now you can see it's everything straight and nice. Only thing I need to do is scale it down. Like not by the width, only the length. And now I need to push it. Like this corner, I have an angle. Before that, one, and now I have one, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 of them. Three, duplicate. So I got four of them. And this base, there is one more is there, which is little angled. So shift rotation switch on and rotate the angle. I can keep it instance, or if I want, I can keep it like the way whatever I want, how or however I want. Match the angle. Like push it slightly outside, slightly down. Now I have this cylinder on the top here also. Now this entire thing is ready. As you can see, the basic structure is almost ready. And now I'll attach this. Done. Now it's basically symmetry, and plus we have that conical shape. So that is something we can do it very easily. And this part, I can see there is another section. This is another like half semicircle kind of shape, and plus it's kind of blocked out. So let me create this. So this one. Element, this section, shift, drag it, half covered, object, separated. Now, polygons, delete it. Say, God, oh, sorry, my bad. This much only, delete it. And this ring also not there, this thickness, this shape. Now border, select the border and move it. And we have a rectangular pipe kind of shape here. And this is lit, it is almost like same. And that boxy shape is there. So I want, if I want, I can definitely create it. Or if I want, I can use this one only directly, because this is already there. That will be like much easier for me to work with this. And element, delete the entire thing. Border, make it straight. Everything is perfect. Only thing, pivot point I need to fix. Select the border and rotate it slightly. Slightly can rotate, and shift, you can extrude and push it down. Create this thing and push it down, scale it nicely. You can see my basic structure is ready. If I want, I can place it nicely, and this thing I can pull it. Like this. Oh, that hole is visible. Sorry, that hole is visible. That means this section, I need to push it down like this. And to fix this, easiest way, I'll apply a symmetry. Instantly ready. So you can see my basic shape and everything I'm creating. Like I created one part and then duplicate, placing everything properly.
Yes,
basic, sir. Right? Basic shape is ready. Now I'll attach everything. So everything is combined. So now I can like add details, reduce detail. I can do everything. So my basic structure is ready. Now I'll see. I'll go to symmetry, pivot point center. Now I'll go here and apply a symmetry. So it will symmetry my entire model. It will make my life way easier. And that center part, I definitely want it. Yeah. See, perfect.
Yes, sir.
I can collapse it. So basic shape, you see, basic shape is ready. And now I want this thing in this side also. So I can apply one more symmetry if I want. Let's apply symmetry. But this time, Y direction. Oh, no, Z direction. Z direction. No. Y direction is nice. And flip it. All right. One sec. I guess pivot point is not, it's correct only. Effect. And I can switch in my vertex snap. And I'll snap it somewhere here. Center. And because if it's giving me any problem, I'll just apply reset X form. So I can see like there are a lot of value. That's why it's creating problem. Reset X form, and collapse it. And then apply symmetry. Symmetry, Y direction, flip it. See?
Yes, sir.
So I'll got this thing. Oh, sorry, my snap off. Move it, create the distance, that in between distance. Your basic shape is ready. Collapse. Now, this side also have the same thing, but only difference is like size. Shift. Copy. This time it's copy and 90 degree. So perfectly 90 degree angle. I can align it nicely if I want. And it's like kind of aligned with the shape, and it's like little like less. So select this, delete this one side. So whenever you have this kind of shape, work only on one side, fix it properly, everything plan it properly, and then like create, then modify it. That will make your life way easier. So I can see angle. We'll change the angle and push it slightly down, but it's somewhere here. It's slightly down and slightly inside. And I can see a 1, 2, 3, 4. Only like basically 50% of this. So I need to delete a couple of things here. Delete. So this also I need to delete. And I can see the sides are not there. Delete. And rest everything is there. And let's go to polygons and delete everything. I don't know what is this. Because of that symmetry, something doubled. That can be managed. Gone. So now I have this shape plus all the edges and everything. Now I can create a triangular shape. Left side. Only thing I have to match, it should align with this perspective. You see, it touches the surface. Now it's aligned properly. And I can apply a symmetry. So I got this thing, see, and angle is, there's a problem. Oh, that's something to fix. I'll do it. So this surface is ready. Now we have that plane, that triangular shape. So easiest way is top view, I'll create the box. And in between, all these loops are not required. Move it down. And it's basically this house is a box. So now I have this surface, and on top of this, I have some parts to align it. Face. I can extrude. Align it nicely, and plus sidewise also there is an angle, so create the angle. My basic surface, basic this thing is ready.
Yes.
So after creating this, like if I feel like, okay, this thing should be slightly bigger than this, like something like this, it should be something like this. We'll create all this surface. And now I have this surface. Now I can align with this. It should be something like this. And rest of this thing, you can see this is again a like box, and there's a cylindrical pipe top of it, and it have some grooves here. So those things one by one we have to create, attach, and create this thing. It's like, you can see, it's like, it's not very difficult. If you will plan it well, nicely, it can do it very easily. And this top part, I can see clearly there is a box, and create this shape. So suppose I have this one, I can duplicate this, copy, how it's changing this section. Now surface, delete, cap it, and then we can like start extruding things one by one, create all